So anyway, we're gonna do this tray that I got. I think I picked this up at TJ Maxx at Christmas time. It's got a little Christmas thing on there. It says Christmas blend hot cocoa served daily. We're gonna paint it. We're gonna take the handles off. So here's the sign. We're gonna paint it. I'm gonna paint it white. We're gonna put a transfer on it. And then we're gonna be using the new Totally Dazzled Ultimate Rhinestone Applicator Kit. All right, so we're gonna paint this. And then I think what we're gonna do now, this does not, these have grooves, but they're, you know, like, they don't go all the way through. They just a little bit. So we're gonna be able to put a transfer over this. I got a really pretty transfer. Wait till you guys see it. You're gonna see. Did it, and I think we're just going to seal this. I have good luck with the Paint Pixie force field when I need to seal something and then put a transfer on it. It always works like a champ. So let's do that. So here we go, we have the board. See, it's got that nice sheen. That was, again, that was Paint Pixie Force Field that you can find over at Paint Pixie. And here is this. I have been wanting to use this for so long. It kind of has a little Valentine's vibe. So I thought it would be, you know, perfect for this project. And all I'm gonna do is peel it off. And we're just going to lay that down. And this should fit. I'm gonna attempt to put it straight in the center. I think that's about good. And just press it down. And then you're gonna get your little, oops, your little burnishing stick. Right here, it comes with your transfer. All right, so you're just going to press. Now this tray did have those lines in there. You're just gonna have to work right over them. Just press, press, press. You get a little bit of an arm workout when you're working on this. Now this should be fairly simple. Cross my fingers, because we're just working on a flat surface. And you're just gonna keep pressing and peeling. This was a perfect transfer. And this is the IOD transfer from that Ephemera Melange. And I got this from, I got that from VintageRetailTherapy.com. Isn't this gonna be like the sweetest little thing? See, I don't know if I wanna wax it. I kinda wanna keep it dark or white, like a bright white. Now we can even add some more transfers, but I'm thinking maybe another flower that you could cut. So you can cut all these transfers apart and you can kind of overlap them. Onto the transfer you have. So let's see, we could put another flower over here. See how this green just kind of matches up? I'm just gonna match it up right next to that butterfly and just put it there. And see how we just added like another bushel over there? You never know that that wasn't on there. So this one I think would be pretty like over here just to give it some fullness over here. So I think I'm just gonna lay that one right there. See how easy that was? So see how we're just adding? I think I might add one more right there just to cover up that gap right there, because I'm just like that. See, you would never know that we cut that out of somebody else. How pretty. I love it. Okay, so now I want to put the handles back on, and I'm not going to lie, but I do want to seal this. So I am going to use Duraclear because I like the shine that Duraclear gives. And then once I get this all on here, shiny with the Duraclear, look at how pretty that is. Do you guys see that shine? See how shiny that is? And just It just pops right out there. So now I'm gonna grab my picker pen. Let's dazzle this up. I think maybe where the butterflies are, we should do like a totally dazzled butterfly. So I think what I'm gonna do is go for this number 9, and that color is the orange shimmer. That one's kind of pretty. That is number 8. That is yellow shimmer. Kind of like the yellow shimmer too. So I'm gonna grab another tray. What other color? And then we can probably do some of this green. So we're just gonna kind of decorate this with some gems. So I'm thinking some different butterflies. I love this one. Look at all that. It's got the sparkle on there. Like, I kind of like that one down here. We can do this one up here. That's like a little bumblebee almost. And then I need a bigger one though. What if we do that one up here? And then I need one more big butterfly. Let's see what I got. I love this one. We're going to use this one. It's got like that gemmy metallic. We could put that one there. All right, so we'll do these three. I want to take these gems and just kind of put them. Let's do some pink. You're going to take your little picker pen with your wax tip. Best thing ever. And I am just going to, I see like these little dots on here. I can't know if you see them, but do you see like all these little markings? Here and here and here and here, maybe one in the center. I'm thinking we should just bling those out. You take your B7000 that comes in your kit, and I'm just gonna start like dropping just a tad of glue right there. And I'm just gonna take and do different colored beads. So I have this yellow one, I have some pink, I have some of the gold, and this is where you can just get kind of creative and just, you know, the B7000, it dries clear, and you can just pick and choose what gems you want where, and just make pretty. You see the sparkle right there on the flowers? So just a little bit of gem. The B7000 glue dries like incredibly fast. All right, let's add the butterflies on, but look at, see all the sparkle that we did just here and there? I know the light is hard to see, but they are super sparkly, okay? I'm gonna use a little bit of hot glue with this too, only because I don't, maybe I'll just do hot glue. This is gonna be on that small one, because these are like, hot glue should work just fine for this. So now I feel like I want to put like a bumblebee or something over here. Something small right over here, because we've got all of this. I feel like I want to put something like right here. I'm thinking maybe that bumblebee. Oh, maybe we'll do this instead of another bug. So this just says love. This was from the Valentine's pack, but I think that's going to be cute. Like right there, or maybe like off on an angle over here. I don't like that. Just do you. Be different. Be you. Be unique. I kind of like that right there. So see, here's what I got so far. See? I just added that little love over there. And look at how vintagey and cute that is. Now, a bow. I want to give her a bow. And she already has a bow on her head, so I'm just gonna make it a little 3D with the bow. Oh my God, tell me she's not so stinking sweet. How cute is that? All right, now, I do wanna put, I think I wanna leave the handles black. See, I like the black. However, I'm gonna give it a little bit of dusting with the, antique gold. All right, so I'm just gonna do a little bit of like here, just on the sides like so, just to break up that just a little bit, and then maybe right around here right up there, straight down the center, just a tad. I'm just using a little bit. Yeah, I know it's gonna snow in here, or it was, and I might have to go out in it. Hopefully they'll cancel my son's practice. So that, see, that's just gonna soften that up just a little bit. I love it. Guys, I think this is darling. Came out stinking adorable. Look at. Can you see all the bling on there? I know my ring light's getting in the way of it, but look at all that bling. Even down at the bottom with the blue, the red up here, we did this red little box down there, and then the bow in her hair, and then the butterflies we made 3D. There's three of them, there's one up here. Isn't that so pretty? Look.
Totally Dazzled sells sparkling rhinestone wedding supplies. Check us out at totallydazzled.com. But before you do, click up here and download our free printable sparkle quotes. Or click down here and watch one of our other awesome tutorials.